Army wanted to review this chapter together, but I do not think I will. Instead, I will review them chapter to chapter. We will release two chapters, miraculously enough, of Nanatsu no Taizai. And I'm glad we did. Why? Because it's just as I predicted. The first chapter is nothing but despair, while the other chapter is nothing but awesome. In fact, in the end, though, I'm still not exactly sure what's happening. But finally, finally, pride and wrath clashes. The original wrath clashes with the true pride, as one could say. And yes, this is me, the angry anime fan, the despair reviewer. Nanatsu no Taizai, chapter 231. Meliodas, having now been consumed by his true dark self, reveals himself to be quite a sadistic monster in this form, once again showing why everyone was so weary of him and not have trusted him ever since, even when he did a heel face turn. He truly is one, as he says to Escanor to watch his mouth as he's in a bad mood, but Escanor is in a good mood because now he can see who is stronger. And so they clash. And while it seems like Escanor is on having fun, Meliodas is the one who having more fun, as he constantly toys with Escanor, making this the first very fight where Escanor truly is outclassed. I mean, people are saying he was outclassed against Estarossa, and yes, he was, but that doesn't exactly count. This also once again shows that Meliodas' true strength really is more legendary strong than that of his brothers. Escanor is not at his peak yet, but it's truly powerful. As he pierces through Escanor's rib and burns it. However, it's also revealed that Escanor... powers also allows him to heal, meaning that it's not that Escanor can take a hit and die. It almost seems to imply that when Escanor is in his day form, he cannot be killed. Not because he is too almighty, we'll get to that later, but more for the fact that it seems that the more and more things happen, the more and more it seems like his wounds are getting healed, the more the sun rises. Of course, Elizabeth being Elizabeth wants Merlin to take down the spell so they can do something. But Merlin for the first time talks back, saying that if Meliodas gets unleashed out, he will undoubtedly kill us all. And since he has been consumed by the dark magic forces inside of himself, Elizabeth has been proven to have the power to purify hatred and evil, but I'm not so sure she could be able to purify this, but it seems to be the only way to do it. Either way, Escanor's halfway noon form appears, the same power he had when he knocked Estarossa off his ass. It's apparently a power level of, 114,000. But according to the author, Escanor's true power is limitless. So either way, it seems like Meliodas is surprised by that. But even that mighty slash is blocked by the powerful force of the ultimate Ten Commandment Meliodas, who taunts Escanor and holds him down with his clawed feet, saying, "The only thing that changed was your tone." Proving that, yes, this is the true Meliodas. Well, not exactly true Meliodas in that true sense, but this is how Meliodas was before he turned good. In essence, this was his original personality. Therefore, it is the true Meliodas. The question is, though, now I'm even more curious. How the hell could the goddess Elizabeth purify such mad and power-hungry sadistic evil? I mean, did she honestly just use her "Let there be light" and purified his malevolence just like that? If you ask me, that feels like a kind of a sheep way. It's understandable if she showed him kindness, but then again, if this is how Meliodas was before, then I see no other reason than the goddess Elizabeth must have purified his evil. And that's the only reason why. In fact, the way she says that, "I'll think of something," when she begs Merlin to take down the barrier, only further seems to confirm that that is the case. But either way, the first round is nothing but despair. While it is awesome to see Escanor still being Escanor, it is kind of frustrating for me to see Meliodas' true power, because that means that there's only going to be future despair. But hey, this is not over yet. We're getting a bonus chapter. So catch me on that review, because I'm gonna have that on a separate video. All in all, awesome fights, but this chapter was nothing but despair in the end. In fact, even Ban's face, he had nothing but despair and frustration in his face. Is that because he has lost his best friend? Is that because he is powerless to save his best friend? Or is it because this is how he feared the captain really was? Give me a false of avenue.